Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is lecture number 9 and in this lecture we will study WTI and OTI. Here WTI is winding temperature indicator while OTI is oil temperature indicator. Depending on the temperature of oil and winding, alarm trip and fans control contacts are operated. See, this is the diagram of transformer. Here we can see that core and windings are enclosed inside the transformer tank. This is bushing of transformer and a current transformer is placed at the bottom of this bushing. The terminal from this current transformer are brought out to the terminal box and this is a sensor bulb. Now we will see the function of this current transformer and this sensor bulb. WTI has sensor bulb placed in the oil filled space on the top of tank. Winding temperature indicator WTI consists of sensor bulb placed in the oil filled pocket in the transformer tank top cover. The bulb is connected to the instrument box by means of two flexible capillary tubes. The heating resistance is connected to CT, which is on winding of transformer. Heating resistance is made up of same material as that of winding. A sensor bulb is placed at the top of transformer, so it is in contact with hottest oil in the transformer. The winding temperature indicator reads the temperature of hottest oil and winding temperature. Now we will see about the winding temperature indicator. It has four mercury switches. See, this is winding temperature indicator. Here you can see these four mercury switches. All these four mercury switches operated for specific value of temperature. See how. Two mercury switches are for fan and motor pump and remaining two are for alarm and trip circuit. So here fan is used to forcing the air and pump is used to forcing the oil. These fans and pumps are used to enhance the cooling of transformer. If temperature rises further, then tripping and alarm circuit get activated. The operation of these switches can be understood by using an example. Suppose temperature of transformer is 66 degree. Okay, so in that case switch 1 get operated, so it turn on the fans for cooling of transformer. Suppose if temperature of transformer further rises, then better cooling need is arising. So in that case switch 2 get operated. When switch 2 get operated, then pumps get turned on. So suppose switch 2 get operated at 76 degree of temperature. So when temperature reaches 76 degree, then pumps get turned on by switch 2. Now if temperature further increases and it reaches to 80 degree, so now switch 3 is set to operate at 80 degree. So when switch 3 operates, then there is alarm circuit activation. Now after that, if temperature further rises and it rises up to 100 degree, now here switch 4 is set to operate at 100 degree. So when temperature reaches 100 degree, switch S4 operates and it initiates that tripping circuit of the transformer. In case of tripping, the transformer get completely isolated from supply. So these are the function of four switches in case of winding temperature indicator. Now what is oil temperature indicator? It has two mercury switches, one for alarm and another for trip. Example, switch 1 operates when temperature is at 75 degree. Okay. In that case, alarm circuit gets activated, but if temperature rises further, then switch 2 gets activated. Suppose it is set to operate at 90 degree. If temperature exceeds 90 degree, then OTI trip signal activates. So in that case, trip signal goes, which isolates the transformer from the supply. So in this way, these switches work. So here it is the practical transformer. Here I ask you the question. you have to locate the winding temperature indicator and oil temperature indicator in this transformer. Please write your answer in the comment box. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you, Jai Shyam.